keeping on top of your mental health alone, you should get paid for that. Make sure that you're not letting shit slip. Make sure you're not burying shit. Make sure you're not painting yourself into a corner and shit. So that's like fucking, yeah, and that's gonna be like the never ending game. Hello, I'm Vinnie Caruana, and this is Zero Platoon. I never really thought seriously about being a musician or being in a band or anything. I was going to hardcore shows on Long Island, just having fun with my friends, and a lot of my friends were in bands, and that was enough. I had a band in ninth grade that I played drums for. I'm not a very good drummer, so I don't even count that. And we never played a show. We just practiced because we just had fun practicing. One of my friends, Daryl, who's in Glassjaw, he had a song on their first EP that had like two vocals, like a lead vocal and this backing vocal that like happened at the same time, so it never really happened live. So he used to be like, you do it, because we used to sing in the car driving around in my car all the time. So he's like, you could sing, you do it. So I would get up and sing on this Glassjaw song. One of the times was in this basement on Long Island somewhere, like out east, and Eddie Reyes was there, who started Taking Back Sunday, wrote a bunch of great songs for them. Not in Taking Back Sunday anymore. At the time, he was Eddie from Clockwise, a band that we all loved growing up. But Eddie was like, hey, you should try out for this new band I'm starting. And I was like, oh my God, Eddie from Clockwise asked me to be in a band. And I was like, my first answer was like, I'm not really a singer, so I guess, you know, no. And he's like, no, you are. Like, you're as much as anybody else is, and you'll figure it out. And I said yes pretty quickly because I was like, fuck it, let me try, you know? So I went to Daryl's parents' house. I didn't have any lyrics. We just took lyrics out of a poetry book of his, put it into a melody over this song, and that's how I tried out, because they didn't have any songs that had words to them. So, and they being like the guys who would end up making up the movie Life. I showed up and was like, here's what I wrote. And I lied because it was really Daryl's words with like us figuring out shit. And they were like, cool, man, you're in. I'm like, holy shit, I'm in a band now? And like, this is summer after I graduated from high school. So I was 17. It was easy in the beginning because I had a lot to write about. I was in my first relationship and we didn't get along because we were crazy kids that were just crazy people and didn't know how to do anything that we were doing. And then the older you get, the realer life gets and the more you have to write about, because you're not just thinking about relationships and love and loss and things like that. You're not complaining about a girl. I don't know how I'd be able to deal with that kind of stuff if I didn't have music. That's how I cope with it. That's part of how I deal with it. And that's how part of how I get it out, and why I'm not like drawing the shades every day, like just drinking myself to death. Music is part of that outlet that helps me be a happy person when I'm happy. And yeah, without music on, me being a fan of music, escaping with it, and me also escaping with my own stuff and addressing it, and all of that is the only reason I'm a functioning human being. When Movie Life broke up, it was on like a Saturday, and on the Monday morning I was in Clinton Hill in Brooklyn on a construction site loading a dumpster, because I called my friend on the Sunday and said, hey, can you give me a job? And he's like, yeah. Daryl from Glassjaw had Automatica. Why don't you join Head Automatica? All right, that sounds good. So I had my toe dipped into the Head Automatica pool, and music was still there somewhere in my life. It wasn't my music. The solo stuff didn't come for a while. so I wasn't confident. I was confident in the fact that I'm gonna write my first songs now. But I didn't think once about it being a solo thing. My mindset was, I'm gonna start a new band, because that's what I know. So the first real music I ever wrote was the first I Am The Avalanche record. A lot of the material was written before the band was, before we had everybody involved. And the rest of it was written with everyone jamming on it and stuff. And then the solo stuff started to go. Anthony Raneri from Bayside, we were playing a college show, Bayside and I Am The Avalanche were playing a college show at Oneonta. And he's like, I'm gonna do some solo shows. You wanna come with me? It's like a weekend. And it was to the point where I was not confident. So I said yes reluctantly. And I brought Brandon and Mike from Avalanche. And they played guitar with me and stuff. Because I still was like, I can't let go of the band thing. Like, you guys come with me, I'll pay you, blah, blah, blah. Like, after a few years of playing solo shows, I was like finally confident and comfortable. I get into the mode of whatever I'm doing. So if I know that there's an Avalanche record that we're gonna be recording, that's what I'm gonna be writing for. If I grab my ukulele or whatever you wanna call this, if I grab this and write something that's clearly not that, I record it and then it just chills. Movielife was never really in the picture throughout the whole Avalanche solo thing because we were broken up for a decade or more. Then when we made the new Movielife record, that was extremely challenging. I'm really proud of the Movielife record, the newest one. Some of my best songs are on there, I think. But in fairness, it does not sound like the Movielife. And that is because the Movielife broke up when I was 23 years old. Me and Brandon were just like, let's do a Movielife record. It's gonna have the spirit, but let's just write it as me and you now. And we did, which is sick. It's the lead singer of Nightmare of You and the lead singer of Avalanche writing a record together. That sounds great to me. For Avalanche, it's a combination of my songwriting and Mike Ireland's songwriting. And us writing songs together, us writing songs separately. Everything me and Mike, just let it happen. It's fucking easy. Me and Mike have written 20 songs over the course of the last year together because we want to make an Avalanche record. We just want to wait until it's right and until it's fucking the best thing we've ever done. It's that, and then as far as my vocals go, it's way more raspy and throaty than the Movielife. That mixed with me and Mike's songwriting kind of intertwined, it just becomes Avalanche immediately. So that, I'm really thankful that we didn't have to think so hard.
And there I was, getting splinters from the bar stool. And who are you to judge? I tried my very best. I'm canceling today. I know I shouldn't stay too long, but I have to carve my name into the bar.
I don't want to make another acoustic record that goes wacka 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 wacka. That's not what I want to do. I don't listen to any music like that. The music that I listen to and the music that I want to make has no fucking rules. I'll go seamlessly into the hardest rap song of the 90s in like New York underground rap, which is what I was listening to in the 90s, along with going to see NoFX and going to see grindy noise bands or going to see MXPX or going to see De La Soul or shit like that. So I'm just gonna do whatever the fuck I want. I'm gonna make sure they're good songs because I want them, I don't want it to just be this like jazz odyssey or something. I just want it to be good songs, but I don't want them to sound like, I have two rock bands. And then I have a hardcore band and then an experimental hardcore metal thing. I don't need any more rock bands. So my solo stuff is gonna be a place for good songs that just sound cool in whatever way I decide they should be in the way that they should be presented.
Waking up like a ghost, scowling at the daytime glow. Cold sheets and regret. I once was young, but they was dead. I slither out of bed and catch a cab to my one true love. I know she'll remember my honest eyes and my crooked smile.
I'm married to a woman who I've been friends with since 2003. We didn't start dating until 2009, and now we've been together for over 10 years. And that's great. That's the really great part of my life. But also, I'm a human being. The world is a fucking nightmare. Inside of here is a nightmare sometimes. As soon as she walks out and goes to work, all right, I'm alone. Let's write. And I write, and there's love songs in there sprinkled throughout, but everything else is like, and that's real. That's the light in my life. And there's the darkness. There's tons of shit to be concerned with. Having my wife is a huge thing. I don't tell her every little thing that goes through my head, because it's just, it won't sound right, because it's just a feeling. It's not, there's no words for it. And I don't want to sweep anything under the rug. I just want to like power through situations and try to come out on the other side every time. It doesn't always work. I think if I didn't have music and I couldn't let things out, I probably would go and see somebody, like I would have gone to see somebody a long time ago. But I've actually never sat down like with a professional and talked. And that's crazy. A lot of people can benefit from that, especially probably me, but 40 years, I actually think I might buy myself a trophy.
More than bridges love to burn, more than death when he gets his turn.
If you want to feel good about feeling bad, I would say Perfecting Loneliness by Jets to Brazil, from front to back, listen to it. It's not like a draw the shades and be a fucking, turn into like a mess. It makes me feel good. It's some of the best Jets to Brazil songs. There are two other Jets to Brazil records, I might argue, that are better than that record, but that just means it's a 9.5 and the other ones are a 10. But as far as the lonely isolation, it's okay to feel this way. And there is little cracks of sunlight here and there on that record. Wow, that is amazing. And then for something that just makes me feel good, it's one song. It's silly. But I love Ween. It's not silly that I love Ween. They made a really gnarly record called The Mollusk. It gets a little trippy and dark at times. But there's a song called Ocean Man on that record that I'll put on while I'm like a lot on tour. Like I'll put it on and sometimes I'll play it 5 times in a row and I'll just be like, and it just makes me feel good. And it's not a song about like, hey everybody, let's feel good. It's just this guy, this ocean man. But it's a good song to like let some sunlight in and just kind of bop for like 3 minutes.